Good day, viewers. Welcome to another edition of Subject Math. Today we'll be talking about number bases. Now, I have a quick introduction here. Now, there are different number bases. The common one is the base 10. Your base 10, when we're talking about base 10, that is what? Your denary. Now, talking about this denary, exchange. You give me 100 naira to take something of 15 naira. Your change is 15 naira. Now, exchange in the common world, or exchange in our society, is done in what? Base 10. That's why if you're giving me 15 naira, I'm giving you back what? 25 naira, after buying something of 25 naira. Because what? The exchange is done in what? Base 10. 20 minus 10 is 10. 100 minus 2 is 98. This particular exchange, or this particular operation, is done in base what? 10, which is what? The denary. Now, so, aside the denary, or the decimal system, we have other bases, which is what? Base 2. Base 2 is known as what? Our binary system. We have what? The quinary, which is, we're talking about what? The base 5. We have the octal system. When I talk about the octal system, we're talking about what? Base 8. Now, from there, let's go to what? Conversion from base 10 to other bases. Now, when we say, if we're converting from base 10 to another base, what do we get to talk about? What are we talking about? Now, we had a question to back up. They said, convert 59 from base this to base 2. So let's go. 2. 2 divided by 5, that's 2. Remember 1. 2 in 19, that is 9. Remember 1. Okay. 2 in 2, 1. 2 in 19, that's 4, okay, 4, remainder 1, 2 here, 7, remainder 0, 2 here, 3, remainder 1, 2 here, 1, remainder 1, 2 here, 0, remainder 1. So after this, you just draw from down, so 59 base 10 is equal to, starting from the bottom to the what, to the top, it becomes 111011 in base 2. So this is how you convert from base 10 to any other base. From base 10 to any other base. Going further, express base 12. Express 12 in base 10 to binary. When I say binary, we're talking about base 2. So your binary has to do with base 2. So we're expressing what? 12. So 2 here, 6, remainder 0. 2 in 6, 3, remainder 0. 2 in 3, 1, remainder 1. 2 in 1, 0, remainder 1. So you drive from down. So your 12 in base 10 is equal to 1100. Base 2. So this is your conversion. This is your what? Your conversion from base, converting base 12 from base 10 to 12 in base 2. Here, so convert 1 1 0. So converting this to base 10. So we're moving forward to what? Converting to base 10. So you have 1 1 0 1 1 base 2. Now this is quite different from what we've been doing earlier. So you number, take the degree of this, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So with this, you then say, once we're starting from this, 1 times what? 2, raised to the power of this, 4, plus 1 times 2, raised to the power of this, 3, plus what? 0 times 2, raised to the power of 2, plus 1 times 2, raised to the power of 1, plus what? 1 times 2, raised to the power of 0. So, 2 raised to the power 4, that's 16. 16 times what? 16 plus 8 plus what? 0 plus 2 plus 1. 16, 8 plus 10, 10 plus 16, that's 26. 26 plus that's equal to what? 27 in base 10. 27 in base 10. So that gives us what? To a final answer. So moving in that light, we have this guy. So this here, you number it. Sorry, you take this degree or numbering 0, 1, 2, 3. So this becomes 1 times 5 raised to the power 3 plus 2 times 5 raised to the power 2 plus times 3 times 5 raised to the power 1 plus 4 times 5 raised to the power 0. 5 raised to the power 3 is 125. 125 times 1, that is what? 125 plus 5 raised to the power 2 is 25. 25 times 2, that's 50. Plus 5 raised to the power 1, that's 5. 5 times 3, that's what? 15. Plus 5 raised to the power 0 is 1. 4 times 4, 4. So with this, 125 plus 50, that is what? 175. 175 plus 19, that is equal to 194 in base 10. So converting this, this is our final answer. Now we're moving further to converting this part that has one decimal. It said express 12.625 in base 12.625 base 10 in base 2. So expressing this guy, what do you think? Now this has two parts. 12.625. This is the whole part, and this is the decimal, and the decimal part. So with this, let's convert the whole part the usual way. 2 in 12, 6, remainder 0, 2 is 6, 3, remainder 0, 2 here, 1 remainder 1, 2 here, 0 remainder 1. So this becomes 1100 in base what? 2. Now, to convert this guy, we're going to convert using decimal. That's what? 0.625. So this 0.625, it has a different what? Approach. It has a different approach from what we know. Since we're converting to base 2, you multiply by what? 2. 0.625 multiplied by 2, that's like 1.25. 1.2, you write the 1 outside, take 0.25. 0.25 multiplied by, sorry, 0.625 multiplied by 2, you got 1.3. So you write your 1, the whole part outside, the decimal part, you continue with it. Multiply by 2, 0.25 multiplied by 2, that's 0.5. 0.5, you write your 0, that's the whole part, then you write your 0.5. 0.5 multiplied by 2, that's going to give us what? 1. That's going to give us what? 1.10. That's 1. I write what? Okay, 0.10. So at this junction, you just take this guy like this from the top to the bottom. So 0.625 is in base 10, in base 2 is now what? 101 in base what? In base 2. So with this, we can now draw to the conclusion that 12.625 in base 10 is now equal to what? 1100.101 base 2. So this is what? That is the final answer to that particular question. Now move ahead. Conversion of base with decimal to base 10. So first to convert this, 101.101. So this is 0, 1, 2. This is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So with this is now starting from here. This is now what? 2, not for S base 2, we're converting to base 10. So this is like, okay, 1 times 2 raised to the power 2 plus 0 times 2 raised to the power 1 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power 0. Plus what? What are we having here? 1 times 2 raised to the power minus 1 plus what? 0 times 2 raised to the power what? Minus 2 plus what? 1 times 2 raised to the power minus 3. So now this is what? 2 raised to the power 2, that's 4. 4 plus 0 plus what? 1. 2 raised to the power 0 is 1. 1 times 1, 1. Plus, this is 2 raised to the power minus 1, negative reciprocal. It becomes what? 1 over 2 plus 0 plus 1 times what? 1 over 8. 2 raised to the power 2 raised to the power minus 3 is equal to what? 1 over what? 2 raised to the power 3. That's equal to 1 over 2 times 2 times 2. That's it. That's how we got what? This guy. So with this is now what? 5 plus what? 1 over 2 plus 1 over 8. So with this development, this is now, the LCM here is what? 5 plus what? The LCM here is what? 8. 8 divided by 2, 4. 4 times 1, 4. Plus 8 divided by 8, 1. 1 times plus 1. 1. So 5 plus what? Plus what? 5 over 8. 5 divided by 8 is equal to 0.5 plus what? 0.625. So 5 plus this is equal to 5.625. That is in what? In base 10. So that is your final answer. If you are converting from what? Well, that's the procedure to convert from base 2 to base 10. From base 2 to base 10. This is 2. 2 raised to the power minus 2. 2 raised to the power minus 1. 2 raised to the power minus 3. So with this, I think we've done justice to converting to what? This particular base. Okay, so big one here, we'll have exercise. I'd like us to try out the exercises. Try it out and look at the answers. So from there, we're going to move directly to addition, subtraction of bases. Okay, so being on speed here, we say find the value of x in base 6. Now, if this becomes that x here is equal to 1001 minus what? 324. Now, this is subtraction in base. So, this becomes what? 101 minus what? 324. Don't forget, you are dealing this in base what? 6. So, dealing with this in base 6, okay? So, 1 minus 4, it's not valid. So you borrow 1 from here. If you borrow 1 from here, it becomes 0. Now, since I'm dealing with this in base 6, this one you borrow from here is what? 6. This one you borrow from here is 6. Because you are dealing with base 6. If it's 5, if you are dealing with base 5, you borrow 1, that one you are borrowing is what? 5. So this becomes 6. If I put the 6 here, if I put it here, take 1, it will be left with 5. Put it here, take 1, it will be left with 5. Put it here, it becomes what? 6 plus 1, 7. 7 minus 4, which is what? 3. 5 minus 2, which is what? 3. 5 minus 3, which is what? 2. And what? Your 0 in base what? In base 6. So this is what? After subtracting this, we have what? 2, 3, 3 base 6. Now pay close attention to this question here. It says express 213 base 4 plus what 202 base 4 in base 10. Expressing is the summation of these two guys. So this is what 213 base 4 plus what 202 base 4. 3 plus 2, that is 5. Because you're dealing in base 4, so 5 divided by 4, that's equal to 1, remainder 1. Your remainder, you write it. This one I say, carry it. 1 plus 0, that's 1. Plus 1, that is equal to what? 2. 2 plus 2, that's what? 4. 4 divided by 4, that is equal to what? 1. Remainder what? 0. You write your remainder, 0. Carry this one. So you bring your 1 down. This is what? After adding this, that's 1021. Sorry, in base 4. But now, the question asks us to express this summation of this in base 10. So converting what 1021 base 4 to base 10. This becomes, you count, take your order, 0, 1, 2, 3. This is 1 times what? 1 times 4 raised to power 3 plus 0 times 4 raised to power what? 2 plus 2 times 4 raised to power 1 plus 1 times 4 raised to power 0. 4 raised to power 3, that is 4 times 4, 16, 16 times 4, 64. 64 times 1 is equal to 1. 64 plus 0 times 8, that is 0 plus 8 plus 1. So 64 plus 8 is 72. 72 plus 1 here is going to give us what? 73 is 10. So the answer to this question is equal to what? 73 in base 10. Now, having this, we are asked to find the subtraction. This is 11011 in base 2 minus 1101. 1 minus 1, that's what? 0. 1 minus 0, that is what? 1. 0 minus 1 is not possible, so you borrow from here. If you borrow from here, this one becomes 0. So if you borrow from that, that's 2. 2 minus 1, that is what? 1. The other one was 0 here. So if I borrow from this, this one becomes 0, put it here 2. 2 minus 1, 1. So 11011 is 2 minus 1101. It's going to give us 1110 base 2. And that's what your final answer. Now, the technical part of this is, each time you borrow, instead of you getting what, you're going to get what, that value, that particular one, base value. That's the only technicality in this, in solving any of this here. Whenever you are borrowing, if I'm borrowing in base 5, if I borrow any single value, it becomes what? I borrow in base 5. I don't know if you're getting me, but you watching this video, the technical part of this is borrowing. If we have what? 4, 3, 5, and this is base what? 6. If I borrow from here, this one, if I borrow 1 from here, it becomes, I'm left with 3. But that one I borrow, it's not 1 because of it's not in base 10. It becomes what? Base 6. That borrowing is in base 6. So 6 plus this now gives me a new value, 9. For this guy, new value was 9. So this is just only the technical part of this thing. Once you understand this part, boom, you are good. Now, this leads us straight to an exercise here. Going straight here to an exercise, which says, given that P is this and Q is this, find what Q minus P, and we'll have our final answer here. So going to the second question, we say find the difference between 42 base 9 and 111 base 5. So we'll have what the final answer what here. And this here, find the difference between 10010 and 1101. And we'll have what the answer here. So these are practice questions. Please don't forget that practice, and I call it again, practice makes you what better. So the more you practice, the better you become. Okay, so at this moment, we're going to be talking about multiplication in base. So multiplication in base, we have an example here which says, calculate 212 base 3, that's what? 212, let's take it from here. 212 base 3 multiplied by 201 base 3. So 1 times 2, this one dealing with 3. So 1 times 2, that's what? 2. 1 times 1, that's 1. 1 times 2, that's what? 2. 0 times this, that's 0. 0 times this, 0. 0 times this, 0. 2 times 2, 4. 4 divided by 3, that's equal to 1, remainder 1. Right? So we're going to be writing 1, carry the remaining what? 1. So 2 times 1, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 divided by 3, that's 1, remainder 0. So you write your remainder 0, carry 1. Okay, so 2 times 2, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. 5 divided by 3, that's what? 1, remainder what? 2. Write your 2. Okay, 2, carry your what? 1. So with this, we now bring this down. This is now what? 2, 1, okay, 3. 3 divided by 3, that's 1, remainder 0. So that becomes, you write your 0, carry your remainder 1 plus this, so this, 2, 1. So with this, after multiplying this, it then gave us this what? Final answer in base 3. So moving ahead, now we have a question here that says, evaluate 1, 1, 1 in base 2 raised to power 2. So to evaluate this, this is like what? 1, 1, 1 base 2 multiplied by 1, 1, 1 base 2. So 1 times 1, 1, 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 1, 1, 1, 1. So at this junction, we add. Don't forget, we are dealing in base 2. So 1, you bring down your 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 divided by 2, that's equal to what? 1, remainder 0. You write your what? Remainder, this one, carry it here. This becomes 1 plus 1 plus 1, that's 3 plus 1, 4. 4 divided by 2, 4 divided by 2, that is equal to what? 2, remainder 0. Bring down, you write your what? Your 0, carry your remainder, carry what? 2. 2 plus 2 plus, that's what? 4. That's 4, right? 4 divided by 2, that is equal to 2, remainder 0. Write your what? This is for this. This is for this. This is for this. So you write your what? You write your 0. Carry 2. Put in your 2 here. 2 plus 1, that's 3. 3 divided by 2, that is what? 1, remainder 1. 1, remainder 1. That one has many. Bring it down. 1 here. So this is what? After multiplying 1, 1, 1 in base 2 raised to the power 2, it gave us the answer 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 base 2. And this is what we have here as our final answer when we what? Expand this particular operation. Okay, so we move ahead towards division. Now this division is a little bit is different from what we've been doing earlier. So whenever you are given division, you have to convert to base 10, divide and convert your answer back to base 2. Now look at, this is in base 2, so we have to convert this guy, it has 1, 1, 1, 1, 0 base, what, 2, to base 10. You have to convert it to base 10. So converting to base 10, this is what, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 1 times 2 raised to the power 4 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power 3 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power 2 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power 1 plus 0 times 2 raised to the power 0. So this is 2 raised to the power 4, which will give us what, 16. 16 times 1, 16 plus 8 plus, okay, this guy here, 4 plus what, 2 raised to the power 1, 2. Plus what? 0. So total sum of this is going to give us what? 20. Okay, this is what? 10, 26, 30. That's going to give us what? 30 in base 10. So convert this, that's 1, 1, 0, base 2. Convert into base 10, this is 0, 1, 2. That's 1 times 2 raised to the power 2 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power 1 plus 0 times 2 raised to the power what? 0. So that's what? 4. 4 times 1, 4 plus what? 6. Okay? 2 raised to the power 1 is 2. 2 times 1, 2. So 4 plus 2, that's equal to what? 6. So what happens here? So the equation says what? Divide what? 30 divided by what? 6. 30 divided by 6 is equal to what? 5. Then convert 5 to base 2. Converting 5 to base 2, this becomes here 2 here, 2, remainder 1. 2 here, 2 in 2, what? 1, remainder 0, and 2 in 1, 0, remainder 1. Therefore, 5 in base 10 is equal to 1, 0, 1 in base 2. So this is what? Your final answer to this particular question. In division, you have to convert to base 10, divide, and then take back your final answer to the base in which the question is given or specified. Now, we move ahead to problems leading to equations. So this says that if 23 base n is equal to 111 base 2, find the value of n. Compare this. This is what 0 1. This is 2 times n raised to the power 1 plus 3 times n raised to the power 0. Combining this to base 10, this is what 0 1 2 3. So this is what 1 times 2 raised to the power 3 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power 2 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power 1 plus 1 times 2 raised to the power 0. So this n raised to the power 1 is n, 2 times n, that's 2n plus n raised to the power 0 is 1. 3 times, don't forget, n in mathematics raised to the power 0 is 1. So 3 times 1, that's 3, is equal to 2 raised to the power 3 is what? 8. 8 times 1, 8 plus 2 raised to the power 2 is 4. 4 times 1, 4 plus 2 raised to the power 1 is 2. 2 times 1, what? 2 plus 2 raised to the power 0 is 1. 1 times 1, 1. So this is now what? 2n plus 3 is equal to 8 plus 2, 10, 14, 15. That's what? 15. So 2n here is equal to 15 minus what? 3. So your 2n here is equal to 15 minus 3. That's what? 12. So n here is equal to 12 divided by 2. So n here is equal to what? Value 6. So with this, we have what? A final answer to this particular theory question from WAEC that came out in the year 1975. Question number 2b. So moving ahead, we have 3 4 base 5 is equal to what? 2 3 base x. Find the value of x. So compare this to base 10. This is 0 1. This is what? 3 times 5 raised to the power 1 plus 4 times 5 raised to the power 0 is equal to 0 1. 2 times x raised to the power 1 plus 3 times x raised to the power 0. 5 raised to the power 1 is 5. 3 times 5 is what? 15 plus 5 raised to the power 0 is 1, 4 times 1 is 4, is equal to what? 2x plus x raised to the power 0 is 1, 3 times 1, 3. So this becomes what? 15 plus 4, which is what? 19. Here is equal to what? 2x plus 3. So this 3 guy comes over here to be 19 minus 3, which is equal to 2x. So 19 minus 3, that's what? 16 is equal to what? 2x, dividing both sides by 2 cancel 2. So x is equal to 16 divided by 2 gives us a positive value, what? 8. So what? X is equal to 8, which makes that particular 23 an octal system. Don't forget what I explained as an octal system. An octal system is any base, any what? Number in base 8. So we are still on questions leading to equation. So look at this guy. 5 2 base x minus 2 4 base x is equal to 2 5 base x. And you have to subtract. Convert it to base 10. This becomes 5 times x plus 2 times x raised to the power 0 minus 2 times x plus put in bracket, plus what? 4 times x raised to the power 0 is equal to what? 25 base x. So this guy here is equal to what? 5x plus what? 2 minus open bracket 2x plus what? 4 is equal to what? 2 times x plus 5 times x raised to the power 0. So this is now what? 5x plus 2 minus 2x minus 4. Why is it minus? Because minus times plus minus, minus times plus minus is equal to what? 2x plus 5. So 5x minus 2x, that's equal to 3x. 3x here plus 2 minus 4 gives us minus 2 is equal to what? 2x plus 5. So this guy comes over, that's 3x minus 2x, because it's crossing over to this side. So the plus will change to what? Minus is equal to 5. This minus comes over here to change to plus. 5 plus 2. So 3x minus 2x will give us s. We want 5 plus 2 here will give us what? 7. So this makes, okay, this makes this particular system a base 7 system, since my x here is equal to the value 7. Okay, now look at this question coming in the light of simultaneous equation. Since we have two unknown x and y, It is a simultaneous equation. So what happens here? Converting to base 10. So starting from this guy, this is like 3 times x raised to the power 1 plus 2 times x raised to the power 0 plus 5 times y raised to the power 1 plus 1 times y raised to the power 0 is equal to what? 10. 10 is already in base 10. So this becomes what? 3x plus x raised to the power 0, that's 1. 2 times 1, 2 plus 5y plus 1 is equal to what? 10. So this is now what? 3x plus 5y is equal to what? 10 minus 3. As what? 3x plus 5y is equal to 7. We call this equation number 1. So since we generated our equation 1, we take this, the second equation, which is what? 2 times what? X raised to the power 1 plus 3 times x raised to the power 0 plus 4 times y raised to the power 1 plus 2 times y raised to the power 0 is equal to 7. So this guy gives us 2x plus what? 3 plus 4y plus 2 is equal to what? 7. So this becomes that 2x here plus 4y is equal to 7 minus 5. That is what? 2. We call this equation 2. So since we have two equations, which are what? Which are 3x plus 5y, which is equal to what? 7. And the second equation, which is what? 2x plus 4y, which is equal to what? 2. Now, to make this equation the same, I say multiply this equation by 2, as I multiply this equation by 3. So as they are x will be the same, so we're able to what? Eliminate. So 2 times 3, that's what? 6x plus 10y is equal to 14, as what? 6x plus 12y is equal to what? 6. Put your elimination sign as your minus sign. So this becomes what? Okay, 6x minus 6x, okay, that's 0. 10y minus 12y, that is what? Minus 2y, as 14 minus 6, which is what? Minus what? Minus 8. Okay, so with this development, we have here that y here is equal to, okay, right, okay, sorry, 14 minus 6 is equal to positive 8. So we have here that 8 here divided by what? Minus what? 2. So y here is equal to 8 divided by minus 2 give us the value of what? Minus 4. So we've gotten our y here to minus 4. What happens? We now say that from equation 2, that 2x plus 4y is equal to what? 2. This is your equation 2. So we say that 2x plus what? 4 open bracket. Instead of writing y here, we write minus 4 is equal to 2. So 2x plus, okay, plus times minus give us minus, 4 times 4 give us 16 is equal to 2. So 2x here is equal to 2 plus, because the 16 is crossing over your equality sign, it changes to what? Plus. So that's what? 2x here is equal to 2 plus 16 gives us what? 18. Dividing both sides by 2, so 2 cancel 2. X is equal to 9. 18 divided by 2, that's equal to what? 9. So with this, our answer x comma y here is equal to what? 9 comma what? Minus 4. So with this, it draws us to what? A conclusion that the answer to this simultaneous equation here is what? 9 and minus 4. So here we have an exercise, our 5 exercises with their answer, except this particular question, which the answer was not provided. It's a why question, 2011, question number 38. You can also refer to your past question if you can't get it. So here I did. Try to attempt this question. It's really, really necessary. This number 5. It's really, really what? Necessary.